changed.
Can we go through this one more time?
Not again, please.
So, you're a test. And I'm about to die today, so you've come here to pick me up like a courier or something.
No, more like a curator. For my gallery of death, you know? Every soul is my exhibit. Cubism, expressionism, realism.
Yeah, but I mean, who's gonna visit this exhibit?
People I wouldn't mind.
Right, okay.
So do you wanna know?
I still have this lingering question that I'm trying to figure out.
What is it?
Like, how am I supposed to say goodbye?
Dear Nam Nam, how are you? I hope you are doing well when you read this letter. I'm now sitting on a stone bench outside the hospital. It's a bit cold today, but fortunately I brought that red scarf you needed for me. I'm about to see the doctor's diagnosis. I don't think I have to see it to know what's going on with me. I know my body. I think I'm about to leave. Nam Nam, are you doing well out there? Are you eating well out there? Why did you choose this school? I haven't heard about it from you. Is it because it's part of New York University? Because of the scholarship, or do you just like it? I mean, you don't have to tell me, I'm just curious. Nam Nam, I heard that everything went well, and I'm so happy for you. Take good care of your health. Nam Nam, I hope that you will make good use of your time abroad to learn. Don't waste it, will you? Of course, pay attention to your health all the time. You don't want to be like me, like now. I can't move on my own, and I always need someone else to help me. I'm not well most of the time, so there might be some difficulties talking to you. Please bear with me. How much do you remember from the time when you were young? At that time, I woke up every day, I prepared breakfast for you, I boiled the medicine for you, and I took you to the kindergarten on my bike. In the afternoon, I would clean the room, pick the vegetables, and then pick you up from the kindergarten, and then bring you a cup of yogurt. At that time, I can still move around, you were always shouting, Grandma, Grandma, Grandma. You made me feel like a hero. Do you know that? Do you still remember that? Time really flies. We were there, abroad, for a year without me even noticing. Have fun. Everything is well, right? I'm really happy for you, and I'll be waiting for you. Love, Grandma.
you know, like to sacrifice one thing in the world in exchange for one day of his life.
But
kind of stupid.
Why not? Do you not want to live longer?
I do want to live longer. I want to live till I'm 30, I think.
30?
Yes.
Stupid.
Okay. Alright, hear me out. I think that, you know, by 30, I'll hopefully have experienced a lot of things in life. I won't yet have to shoulder too many responsibilities, and I think that the good thing about dying at the age of 30 is that you wouldn't have to endure all those stupid, disgusting things like aging and, I don't know, diseases and pains and financial burdens. You just kind of live life good and that's it, no?
I don't know. I'm really trying to see where it comes from.
And you?
What about me?
When do you want to die? So think about it. Couldn't the world, I don't know, do so much better if we didn't have if we didn't have words to denote concepts like death and goodbye and
what?
Hear me out, right? Like you know how in some languages the idea of yesterday and tomorrow are denoted by the same word, or like in some other languages there just isn't even a future tense, right? And I think that says a lot about the kinds of people who use those language, right? So. I don't know, like, imagine if we did away with the, like, words death and goodbye.
But will it make it easier for you?
I don't know, you tell me. documented everything that I did, like everything that I ate, whenever I ate, what I did at whichever time. Yeah.
That's sweet of her.
That's very sweet of her. And it's so full. Okay, check this out, yeah? 25th of December, 2003, the first day that my babies turned 1 year old. 26th of December, 10:23 a.m., one bowl of banana puree, 2:38 p.m., 300 milliliters of milk, puked, 4:11 p.m., slept for half an hour, changed his diaper, 7:50 p.m., two capsules of fish oil, apple puree, it just goes on. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any idea where she kept it?
I don't know. I feel like this is the kind of stuff that like my parents would deem useless, and I think that at some point before in my life I really would have kind of agreed with them. But no, I don't know, like thinking back, I feel like it's really, really rare for someone to pay such close attention to you at such a young age, and it's really quite a blessing that like this exists, you know?
Yeah. I think there's so much love on your end. I wish my grandma did the same thing for me. Because if she did so, I'd feel like she's never left me. So do you want to, wait. What do you plan on doing after being discharged?
What I plan on doing after being discharged? I don't know, it's not like I really have much time to think about it yet. I feel like all of this is just so much to process. I don't know, it feels like it's going to take forever to process it.
Yeah.
I feel like it's so silly that I used to think that death is something that just happens to you. Like at this point it really doesn't feel like it just happens, it's just gonna keep haunting you forever, you know? Like every person that I meet, I'm worried that it's the last person I'm gonna meet. Every word that I say, I'm afraid that it's the last thing that I'm going to be saying. And I feel like as a kid you used to think that saying hello is the most difficult thing in the world, but really saying goodbye is so much harder.
Goodbye, sir.
Goodbye, sir.
Someone says death is like a journey through a ferris wheel. Before you get onto your ferris wheel, you typically need tickets, right? So people get in line to get tickets. Once they get the tickets, they go and sit inside the ferris wheel and wait for it to start. And it starts. They go up slowly. They get a beautiful view at the top. And before they could linger for longer, they go back down, slowly, bidding goodbye to the view, to other people who just had the same view, and who also happen to be part of the view. And then they are back on the ground. They get out, and someone else comes in. This is them.
Dear Grandma, hi, I'm sorry. This is the return letter that I was supposed to send to you 10 years ago. In response to the letter that you'd sent me 10 years ago before you passed, and I never had the courage to open it. So today, please let me write back to you. It's been 10 years, and I think about you. Not every day, but sometimes, when I walk by that little garden, by our home, I'd look at that bridge out of the window and realize it was your favorite place. I think about those things sometimes, you know? Grandma, I remember everything from my childhood. I remember that day that it was raining and you rode the bike to pick me up. And on the way home, that drizzle ruined a heavy rain, so we took shelter at that barber shop down the corner. And I was so scared that day. I was hiding in your arms and looking out at the rain. I remember we were playing hide and seek at the park, remember? And your leg had accidentally bumped into that stone pillar and left a bruise. And I also remember that snowy day. You know, when we built that little snowman downstairs that melted away very quickly. Grandma, it's not that I remember what happened in my childhood, it's that I only remember what happened. And as I grew up and we stopped living together, and the only time that we shared in the day was just 30 minutes of dinner time, I feel like our collective memories kind of faded away and our connection weakened. And Grandma, every time I left home, I'd go to you and I'd say goodbye to you. And when you started to have difficulties walking and barely got out of bed, I'd come to your bed. Conversation would be pretty similar every time. I'd say I'm gonna leave and say, okay, take care of yourself. I'm getting worse, but I'll try to wait for you. So, Grandma, this time you can come and sit in my dream, and I'll be the one waiting for you. Love, Grandma.
Thank you. 好可惜啊，你还年轻，你还有那么大的潜力。
The daisies bloom again. You see it? It's okay if you don't. I am just here to let you know.
You've done a lot of amazing things in your life. There are many people who have been inspired to follow their dreams because of you. And perhaps you yourself have found the goal you wanted. This life is best if there are no regrets. And if there are regrets,Please believe that someone who is willing to come and see you will pick up your expectations and finish it. There will be those who come after you. You are already amazing.
感谢你曾带给我温暖的微笑。
I will list everything wrong you have done, so that the gatekeeper at paradise or hell will cut you some slack.
Earlier today, I've been thinking that actually no one in my generation that I know has died yet, and I guess you're the first. I never knew you well. We have been together in a competition. I spoke to you. I knew you from this funny student union as a candidate when you were still 15 when I was 16. Not that much of a difference, but still. You were a middle school student, but I was a high school student, and you're running for the president, and you said thatYour advantage was your gentleness. Why? I never asked you this, and I guess I never will. You are a nice person. I'm going to think of you another time when someone says gentleness to me, for sure.
Do you have anything left unfinished or unsaid? I can help you if that's what you'd like.
你是一只很可爱很可爱的小猫，给这个世界带来了太多太多的温柔和善意了。在去往另一个世界的路上，我相信你一定会顺利的。我想命运也终究会让我们再度相见，所以放心吧。
I want to say that you're very kind. Hey, although I couldn't say that we know each other well, in the short time we shared together, I can feel your kindness.All the people who met you are very lucky.
Hi. How is it going? Perhaps this is really not the right place to ask you this question. But I'll do it anyways. And wishfully hope one night I could ask you this question again. Perhaps in my dream. And hear your response.I'm doing good. Thanks.
很高兴认识过你，希望漫天神佛可以保佑你这一路顺顺利利。若有来生，望你平安无虞，得偿所愿，长命百岁。
抱歉，隔了你两次接受的面试。这件事从初中记到现在，但兜兜转转，我最后还是选上了剧场。不过我还是不敢走上舞台，现在决心当个观众了。真诚地说，其实我不认识你，也不了解你对活着的定义。如果你希望的话，祝福你有一个美好的下辈子，或者不要再来到地球。
我听说啊，人类分别在65万小时之后，会氧化成风，变成同一杯啤酒上两朵相连的泡沫。就算今天消散在风里，那也不要紧，我们总会重逢。因为如果时间是错觉，那么我们都能长存。以后也请多关照，期待我们在某一颗麦芽发酵的瞬间再次相遇。
I never thought I would see you again in this place, in a box.It's been 10 years since we've seen each other. It was just a glance in a class and we got to know each other and became strangers just like in the contact page. If you lived happily and already did what you like, then it is good. Wouldn't it be happier to die in the most youthful days than to be left alive to endure all the trials of the world? Who knows?
希望我们下辈子还可以见面。
希望没有痛苦，希望我们下辈子还是好的朋友。
I'm sorry that you won't be able to continue living. I've always felt that you're a good person who had the potential to live a good life. It's not that you could be rich or something, but I think you have the ability and characteristic to live an ordinary life with taste. I'm sorry that your possibilities are gone here, and I hope that in your next life, you cannot die young and enjoy the good things on earth more fully.
Work hard there and earn some money. I hope that when I get there, you're already rich and living in a big house. If you need something, just let me know via drink. Or maybe I should just store something in your place so that it will be more convenient when I come. Also, remember to bless me, all right? And I love you forever.